the representative from KAI. I now give the floor to the representative from the Instituto Autor. You have the floor.
Instituto Autor, thank you, Mr. Chair. For those who don't know what Instituto Autor is, we are a non-profit research organization based in Spain, focused on the study and analysis of copyrights from a legal and business approach, developing also many training courses in this field. First, briefly, I would like to say it is a pity dedicating just one day, the last day of the committee, to copyrights, considering the very interesting topics that has been opened, such as the protection of copyrights in the online field, or the very satisfying proposals related to the resale right made by Senegal and Congo at the right for directors of theaters made by the Federation of Russia, which we support. With respect to copyrights in the digital environment, we would like to remark the brainstorming exercise organized by WIPO on April 6 and 7, whose conclusions prepared by Mr. Pierre Sirinelli are uploaded on the website. Among those conclusions, we would like to emphasize the necessity of clarifying the notion of communication to the public established in the WIPO treaties. Unfortunately, the European Court of Justice and some other national tribunals have been interpreting this right in a way that we think is contrary to the spirit of the original agreement reached by the contracting parties of these treaties, for example in the well-known Svensson, Bestwater or GS Media cases. In fact, it seems the communication to the public right is being subject to a kind of exhaustion principle, as the distribution right can be subject to, according to the provision established in Article 6.2 of the WIPO Copyright Treaty, always due to a wrong interpretation of the international laws by the tribunal. It is important to say that the European Court of Justice has motivated some of this ruling according to the WIPO guides, so we strongly believe that a new WIPO guide should be carried out in order to clarify the notion of communication to the public, for making sure that the right holders may authorize the communication to the public uses done by an organization other than the original one. In a traditional sense, in the sense of Article 11 bis.1 of Bern Convention, warranting the neutrality of law in the digital environment. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.